Hello, and welcome to Vincent Codes Finance. In this video, I'll show you how to set up VS Code for writing in LaTeX. So there are already plenty of editors that are specialized for LaTeX. Why would I want to use VS Code for that? For me, the main reasons were it provides a uniform workspace where I can do both my research and the writing in the same interface. So I can do my research coding and the writing in the same software. Second, it is really extensible. So there's a lot of extensions that are already available that will be useful for writing in LaTeX. Third, VS Code has a built-in support for version control systems such as Git and GitHub, so you can track your changes easily in your code and collaborate with others. And finally, VS Code is really customizable, so I can really set it up the way I want. By the way, if those are topics that you find interesting, maybe like so that others also get notified of this video, and think about subscribing so that you get notified of my future videos. For this video, I'll assume that you have a working knowledge of LaTeX and that you have a working LaTeX distribution on your computer. If you don't, well, you can add to the LaTeX project website, so latex-project.org, and from there you can just download the distribution for your own system. Okay, so here's my VS Code interface. The first thing I'd want to do, because writing is going to be a somewhat different task than just coding, is I'll create a new profile that I'll use specifically for writing in LaTeX. That way, I'll be able to configure all my VS Code for tasks that are specific to writing. So in order to do that, I will come here into Manage Profile. Then I will create a new profile, and I'll create just an empty one. So I won't copy from anything. So I'll just call it LaTeX. And finally, I'll choose an icon that is quite representative of writing. So maybe some coffee here. When I'm ready, I'll click create. Now I've got a new profile. First thing I'll do is I'll change the theme so that it is a bit more light. I like to write with a lighter theme, so this will be good. And then I will install the only extension that I actually need to run LaTeX on my computer, which is LaTeX Workshop. So all I have to do is search for LaTeX and then not use the first one, but choose LaTeX Workshop. I'll install this one. There are a few others that you can look into, but this is the only one that's actually needed. Okay, once it's installed, I'll get an extra icon for text. So this is where all the features will live, but I won't even need to look at these features directly most of the time. All I have to do is open my paper. So here I've got a really sample paper. It is pretty much like a basic paper. It has kind of one section here. Maybe I'll include the second section. So I've got two sections and separate files. So I have all of this. Now, all I have to do to compile my LaTeX is press save. It will actually run. I don't see it yet, but I can just open the preview panel to have a look at my PDF right directly here in my VS Code. So now my paper is compiled. I could actually go here. So with F12, I can go to the definition. So all I have to do is put my cursor here, FN F12. I can make use of all these VS Code features to go into definition and navigate into my paper. So this is kind of just random text, but I can still add some text here. If I save, the paper will recompile automatically. So how did LaTeX Workshop know that once I've saved this file, the other one has to be updated, and it didn't compile this file, it compiled this file? Well, it does follow a few rules to find your root file. So you can actually explicitly set it in your files if you want. But by default, what it's gonna do, it's gonna look into the root of your directory and try to find a tech file that has either a document class here or at least a begin document tag, so that you are sure that this file is meant to create a PDF. So once it's found that file, well, it assumes that all the other files are linked to that one. One thing that can get really confusing when you write a long paper in LaTeX is finding your way to your different tech files and the corresponding place in your PDF file. Fortunately, LaTeX Workshop supports SyncTeX, which is a mechanism for navigating and searching for links between different locations. So for example, here, if I just click on my abstract and do Command Option J, it will highlight in my paper, in my PDF, the location for this part. I can also do the reverse, where I can just say, go here in this introduction, the part here, where is it in my paper? Well, then it's just command click on Mac or control click on Windows, and it will take you exactly where you want to be. Another useful thing with this SyncTeX is when you have a link. So for example, here I'm in my second section. If I add a reference to my introduction, my first section here in my paper, and I compile this, I'll see that I've got the number, so the reference to this section that was added here. But now if I hover over that reference, I can click on View on PDF, and it will just highlight the part that I'm referencing here. Another really, really nice feature that I like of VS Code is formatting. So VS Code supports a lot of formatter. I've been using that like crazy for my code. It's been a life-changing experience. Now my code is tidy. Not so much for my LaTeX code. It used to be super, super messy. But now with LaTeX Workshop in VS Code, I can actually format my LaTeX code as well. And in order to do that, actually, LaTeX Workshop doesn't include the formatting itself. It uses a third-party software called LaTeX Indent, so you will have to install it if you want to use this feature. In order to use LaTeX Indent, follow the link in the description and then look at how you can install it for your system, and then make sure that it is in your path. So for me, I'm on a Mac. I looked at the Mac section of the appendix, which was here, and then I just used Homebrew. So I copied this bit here in my terminal to use Homebrew to install it. And after that, everything worked. Once you've got that all installed, by default, LaTeX Workshop will format your code when you want it. For that, you'll need to set it as your default formatter. So let's try a simple example. So I'll just write just an extension with alignment. So for that, I can actually use the snippet BAL all in caps. When I type enter, it will create my begin align and end align. So that's another feature of LaTeX Workshop. Look into it. I won't list them all. There's tons of snippets there that they have that are installed by default, so that you can really be more productive when using LaTeX. Okay, so now I've got my align here. I'll just write a simple simple equation. So f of x. Square, right? Something like that. Now, if I save, I'll see that my equation has been added in this page here. So now I've got my equation. If I actually hover over this, LaTeX Workshop will provide a preview of that equation. So I don't even have to save and compile before I can actually look and preview my equation. And now, once I've done that, if I want, I could format my document. So one thing to do is to just go into format. It might ask you, if it's not set up, to set LaTeX Workshop as your default formatter. For me, it was already configured. So once you got that, you see everything lines up nicely. So it will format a lot of things, and it is super, super useful. Another part of my LaTeX and a coding environment that tends to get really, really messy are my BibTeX files. So I sometimes use Zotero to manage my libraries, but when I'm in a rush editing, I'll often just copy the BibTeX keys from Google Scholar or another source like that, put them in my BibTeX file, and then they end up all over the place, formatted all differently. It becomes really, really messy. If I go here, this is what kind of one of these files might look like, right? So it's not too bad, but you see, like, they're not in alphabetical order. Everything is not that good. If I just format it, now it's all lined up. It's all good. What I really, really want to add that I find super, super useful is another feature that you need to activate in your settings. So for this feature, just open the command palette and look for user settings JSON or workspace setting, depending on how you wanna, which one you wanna set up. So for me, it will be the user's settings. So this is the settings that are specific to my profile. So what I'll wanna add here is a setting to tell VS Code and LaTeX Workshop to not only align and format my bib entry, but also sort them by alphabetical order. If you go on the LaTeX Workshop website, the documentation is quite massive. There are tons of options there that you can set manually. LaTeX Workshops provides three commands for formatting BibTeX file. One is to sort the file. The other one is to align the fields, and the third command is to perform both at once. Which one gets called when you format your BibTeX file depends on your settings. So what I will do is I will add this entry here and I will set it to true. And now when I do that, if I come here and format my document, now it sorted everything by alphabetical order. I enjoy formatting so much that I actually recommend setting it so that it formats all your document automatically on save. So in order to do that, you go into your settings here, and then you can look for format on save. And here I will activate format on save. And now whenever I save my document, it will get reformatted. By the way, if you're using Zotero as your reference managers, there are many VS Code extensions to interact with Zotero directly from VS Code. So you can actually query your library from VS Code if you use one of those. I showed you earlier how you can just hover over equations to get a preview of that equation. That's not the only preview that is available in VS Code. For example, if I'm citing a paper, I might open my brackets like this. VS Code and LaTeX Workshop will detect all the entries in my BibTeX file. So I'll have a picker here. So I'll pick the first one here. And now I can actually hover over this and see what paper this is referencing. And if I save, again, everything gets formatted. I can look at my preview, and now I've got a reference bibliography that's there. The reference is there. It is the one that was being previewed here. Now, a really painful part of dealing with LaTeX is dealing with errors. So for example, here, instead of having some, maybe I had a typo here and I used a keyword that just doesn't exist. If I try to compile, I will get an error message. So I can actually open the compiler log to see the actual error. That's what I would do in my other editors. But in VS Code, LaTeX Workshop will actually try to highlight the part where the error is coming from and will tell you the error. So here would tell you there is an undefined control sequence here. There are no quick fixes available for that, but still it will tell you there is an error here. If you're stuck One thing that I really, really enjoy using with VS Code is GitHub Copilot. So if you use GitHub Copilot and you install the Copilot. So now I've got my error. I could actually highlight it here, maybe ask Copilot with the inline chat. So I'm getting an error. Can you find a typo? Which is usually my what I tend to do. Fix the error, I would replace the undefined control sequence so sum with the correct LaTeX command sum in both instances. Okay, so that's really nice. I could accept this change. It will actually fix it for me. And now I save and my code is fixed. Finally, if you want to see more features, well, you can go here on the tech icon on the toolbar, and then you'll see a few commands to build or clean your files, or to just view the PDF either in VS Code or in an external viewer, which will open a preview on my Mac. Or you can look at different things. So you can come here to sort your BibTex. You can look at different settings for SyncTech. You can view your log messages. You can also come here and see the structure of your file. So you can browse the structure of your file directly. And you can also see kind of snippets. So the symbol viewer, and there's also one for graphs if you want. So that's all you need to run LaTeX on VS Code. There are a few other extensions that I find useful. So for example, I use the Grammarly extension for syntax and kind of writing recommendations. There are other spell checkers and grammar checkers available out there. And I really recommend, if you're not doing that already, to look into using source control. So Git and GitHub, for example, to keep track of changes in your tech files. Thank you for listening. If you enjoyed this video, please like, and also consider subscribing to the channel so that you get notified of my future videos.